welcome to Master Pierce. We can only do so much recording outside of the store, but this is what we have as far as signage goes. We'll discuss this as we go. So what we're going to do is I'd like you to come over here. I'd like you to pan this whole section here because we can't get outside the mall. By request of the mall, of course. Okay, so let's go back
here.
Hold on,
I've got to make a full 360.
Yeah, but if you like make that.
I know.
Wait.
Go ahead.
Bummer. Hopefully we don't get in trouble for that. Okay. Point of sale. We keep gloves up here for handling any kind of jewelry. And of course, keep paperwork and things in the store down here. You can always use the zoom function while you're in there and catch it.
Yeah, but it's okay. I can see it.
All right, cool. So keep paperwork and things in the store here, orders and whatnot. General cleaning supplies, mostly for the glass and whatnot, under here. This is going to be of immediate use, and paper towels under there as well. Other cleaning supplies are stored in the back of the bathroom. Then, of course, it's like the utility drawer. Got all of our stuff. Aftercare. We've got some more things stored in here as well. Backup iPad. Some other stuff as far as like displays and whatnot go, other tools, instruments and things, ring measuring device and whatnot, labels, promotional cards and stuff, extra like pieces of jewelry and whatnot, bags and things of the sort, more jewelry, a lot of jewelry like bangles, bracelets, necklaces, things like that, they're in a mall. Gift boxes for when we send things out the door. We put our gift cards in them too. Jewelry as well, in some cases. Paper for printer, nice paper for printing pictures, rubber bands, office supplies. We're gonna have some more O-rings in here and whatnot. Some extra PTFE, more beads, more display stuff, as you can see, first aid stuff, my phone box. More jewelry, bracelets, necklaces, and stuff, and some other things that were here long before I was. It's all jewelry, but that's what it is. So we have a point of sale here, point of sale over here. And then, of course, we have our media station type deals where we've been able to create our website, handle most social media things, check emails, things like that without impeding flow of traffic. Water thing, because it's required by law, because of the capacity we're allowed to have.
Signage for the mirrors.
Oh yeah, signage for the mirrors. Let's talk about that real quick. So we have these strategically placed anywhere that there's a mirror. Like there's a mirror and somebody's going to want to see there, there, here. It's going to say do not touch or remove jewelry in studio. If you need assistance, we will help you. We don't want people touching things. And then of course we do have business cards. I'm out of business cards because I'm the most popular and handsome. Aftercare pamphlets as well. So we're going to have a bunch of information and somewhere to write some information there. So we're making sure that our customer or our clients are completely informed on everything that they can be informed on and sending them out the door with something to read. Moving on. Is there anything else we need to do? Okay, so we're actually getting licensed for tattooing. This is getting set up currently as two tattoo stations. However, it doesn't affect the piercing aspect of things, so we're just going to go ahead and leave that all alone. So over here we have booth A and booth B. Booth A is where we're going to handle, waiting area for our customers. Forgot about that. Alright. Booth A is where we're going to do most of our piercing work. You come in and then do a 360 of the room. to the best of our abilities. So
I'm gonna do that one more time. I'm just gonna do it this way instead.
Perfect. So
hang on.
As you can see, we have a medical examination table of awesomeness. Over here, we're gonna have ourselves a very distinct red area. This is where anything that is biohazardous is going to go, whether it be instruments, sharps, or our biohazardous waste. Certificates and stuff that are required to be up on the wall are gonna be done over here. Clients usually can hang out over here as well. If somebody brings a friend in, family, or mom or dad needs to be in the room. We do have stuff to look at. People find this interesting. They enjoy it. Some way to listen to music. Some clients prefer to listen to music when we're working on projects and things of the sort. Then, of course, we have our glove rack here, dental bibs here. Let's start with jewelry. This is our jewelry racks. So everything's going to be in bags. So when we get it from our provider, if it's something that we normally use and it's regular stock, then it will be placed in these drawers here until used. Over here, we're gonna have most all marking and prep kind of stuff. Alcohol pads, we're gonna have our op marks, the caps. I use those for beads sometimes when I'm working with things. We've got a couple biopsy punches in here, and then of course sterile lube, toothpicks, band-aids, jewelry bags, iodine, bandages, and then we have some corks. There's a bottle of gentian violet over there as well, and then a little light, some PTFE. And some ammonia inhalants, which I've never had to use, but I felt cool having them. Then we have the proven iodine swab sticks here. These are all going to be labeled, so this is what we usually use. You have the non-sterile gauze stored over here, and then the sterile cotton tipped applicators over here, all in containers that are closed and that are non-porous and can be very easily cleaned or sanitized. And then more band-aids in the back. Band-aids for everybody. We keep our steriles over here. Some of them, anyway. There's a lot of steriles in shop, so. And then there's our bags, our basic trash bags and our red bags for our bio waste. Now, trash cans are always gonna be on a hands-free type deal. And then we also do have our sterile gloves here. We have more sterile gloves down here. And this is an empty storage drawer. Sure, we'll fill it eventually. Over here we keep more supplies. We do have our alcohol, some Q-tips and whatnot for things and stuff. Then we have some more cotton tipped applicators, sterile lube, rubber bands, some more op marks, some more masks, face masks, things of that nature, more iodine, an extra bottle of biotin. Some people ask about it, it's good to have one. We're just gonna say that this is an example of why we don't like using certain things. We were trying an aftercare there. Looks like another bottle of gentian over here. So that's cool. We got plenty of gentian floating around. Gentian, or whatever you wanna call it. Wipes. Some more mouth rinse. This was one from the other booth, I think, that got mixed. This was phased out, HIPAA cleanse. We don't even use that anymore, but we still have a bottle around. Over here we're gonna do, this is where we keep our statum over here. Cassette, things live in the cassette. So, surgical trays is where we'll store some things such as tapers, commonly used tapers, all the way up to like 10 gauge, I think some 8 gauge. And then of course, receiving tubes and things of that nature will be kept there. We will keep our sterilization integrator strips, so it'll look something kind of like this here, and all these will stay in there, and it will have the initials on it, as well as any kind of other information pertaining to that particular load, so that the customer can identify their piece, labeled, enveloped, and then put away. And then records here, of course, and then waste will be down here. So this is actually where we'll keep the, this is actually where we keep the tank. That's what I call it. The jug of doom. And of course up here, empty storage for the most part, other than we do have some dental bibs and some things that I had ordered for jewelry making stuff. And then over here, We have more sterile gauze, or non-sterile gauze, I'm sorry, and sterile gloves up top there. I wonder if those are mediums. I'll check later. Anodizing section. We've kept some tubes from our needles for whatever reason it might be needed for. I think Kayla just likes to collect them.
I do.
And then we have, of course, our anodizer and our little station right here that's getting rinsed and used. And then
jewelry
we have,
working tools.
Yeah, jewelry working tools, different size cathodes, different anodes, different types of things. So if we want to use a paintbrush or something to create a different artistic feel, then we can do so. Dipping methods, and then of course tapping methods, touching methods, things of the sort. All the different anodizing stuff here. We're going to keep sharps here, other than biopsy punches, those are over there. We usually keep pre-cut CSR wrap here for our sterile draping. That's my preferred method. And then more non-sterile gauze. A lot of this stuff will be used for that. A lot of that stuff will be used for prep. And then larger gauge tapers will be over here. And then autoclave process tools. Now, this is going to be, once tools are processed and they're autoclaved, then they're going to be transferred into these containers. So these containers will usually be taken into the clean room. And then loaded and then brought back into here. So that's how that works. And then empty drawer and a fire extinguisher. You gotta have a fire extinguisher.
It's important.
Alright, and then we come back here, of course.
Can you open this one? So I can get a little pan. Okay. Let me slide.
Okay, so we'll start here. Green squares usually going to indicate clean, right? So once you're here, you're probably going to be clean anyway. The sink is operated off a foot pedal, obviously. We do have right here literature on how you're supposed to be drying your hands or washing your hands. I do apologize. So that'll tell you right there. So there's instructions. And over here we have a designated hand washing sign. Yeah, so that's awesome. So you got your green here. You got your green here. And you got your green here. Now these are going to be places where things are going to be clean. So once you leave here, you're probably going to be clean as long as you actually wash your hands. Autoclave here, once things come out, they are clean, they get moved over here, or the bins from in there that I was telling you about with the autoclave process tools will get moved to here. These will be put here, and then of course they'll be handled with tongs and things of the sort, and these will get sterilized with it, and that's how everything gets transferred from clave to
storage.
There we go. Now, the yellow section is going to be like working section. So this is where you would do any kind of tool processing. We keep a screen down here for the ultrasonic, which is going to be under here. Okay, so this is the ultrasonic. This is getting dumped out every night. We're in the process of doing that at the end of the night. So that's in a cabinet. That way we can make sure not to make the air gross.
The separation for the...
Oh, yes. Okay, so we have this plexiglass barrier here. We have one in store. It just needs to be cut to size to go here. And that's going to separate the yellow section from the green section. This is going to be tool working area. That's why it's yellow. This is where we're going to be working on things, where things get rinsed or sorted out or enzymed, or if it's client jewelry, it's going to need to be prepped for ultrasonic. Things like that. That will all happen here. Tool processing section. Hand washing not permitted in this sink. Or this one, or this one.
Cabinets.
Oh, cabinets. Up here, we got
jewelry bags.
Ton of them, as a matter of fact. Gloves right here, or just basic box gloves. And then over here we have, well,
all kinds of stuff. Autoclave pouches, cups, just random odds and ends that we use for processing.
All kinds of random stuff that we use. Hold on, sorry, I didn't touch that without gloves. And then over there, if you wanted to show them real quickly, you have CSR wrapped in the clean section, and then there's storage of some, those are like tapers, some old needles that we kind of phased out, but we just have them stored. Another ultrasonic or backup one, which I was debating on using as a clean ultrasonic for processing jewelry when we get it, but we use manufacturers that are so good at their damn job, we don't have to. And then, of course, all of our paperwork is up here.
In a white wall barrier.
Yeah, in a white wall barrier.
Well, like the containers that they're in.
Okay.
You need to open those as well.
Oh. Okay.
Bags.
Well, more, the black bags, right? The retail bags. So there's more black bags down there. We've got catalogs and things of the sort down here.
Stuff for the health department.
Yeah, stuff for the health department. This
spores.
Spore tests and siphon hose, I suppose that would be what that would be for.
Yes, it is. And I think it's
more envelopes, and then it's probably going to be pretty empty from there,
yep.
And empty from there. And then we have our red section here. I have a table that needs to actually come back here. This will be set on the table to get that off of the floor. So that way it's not getting dissolved with a mop.
That's the processing room.
Yeah, that's our processing room. And then over here, this will be turned into another hand washing station simply because according to the rules and regulations, there needs to be another sink for the artists. Now, when we wash our hands here, everything is on swinging doors, so you can elbow, you can back through any of that sort of thing, foot, whatever, that way you're not touching anything on the way through. So there is that. Let's go ahead and jump in here and then we'll come back to the bathroom.
Okay.
So this is going to be the second booth. Now this booth is primarily going to be used for jewelry changes and some piercing. It's capable of handling piercings. We just minimize it. So have you do the 360 there.
Go ahead.
Okay, so again, with the jewelry being in its packages, and out here, as you can see, there's a smaller selection in here. A lot of ring work happens in here. We keep some basic stuff, but mostly there's like ring work and a lot of jewelry change stuff. This is also where we do a lot of consultations for people. We do keep some sharps here, marking stuff, integrator strips, prep, alcohol pad, some iodine here, jewelry bags, clave logging strip bags. And then you have the non-sterile gauzes up here. This is a lot of this is empty except for like there's some pens in here and then some envelopes in here. Toothpicks, more jewelry, random jewelry. So awesome. Now we keep our sterile lube here, provolone iodine here, and then cotton tipped applicators. Keep some wound wash back here as well. Masks, we use the wipe here. Some mirror and whatnot, and all the other stuff that we need for cleaning and rinse cups, dental bibs, and then our log for our clave, which is right here. The waste for this one is actually going to be here. Let me move this. It's actually going to be under there. So, and there's a safe there. That's for
monies.
Well, yeah, we're not gonna tell you that's where it's for monies, but you don't need to know that. Anyways. We got more jewelry down here. There's another jewelry rack right here that's going to carry a whole bunch of rings. This is where we keep a lot of seam rings. And then tool clean, autoclave process, tool storage, and an extra gallon of water. And then trash can, of course, same story. I don't want to touch it. And then gloves. And then, of course, same thing, our red section with our hands-free trash cans. And then stainless steel shelf, steel tray, sharps container. Certs. And then we got a jewelry cabinet in here, or a display case, but we tend to put just catalogs and stuff in here. So, and some other things that the clients like to look at, and other ways to, you know, do consultation stuff. Over here, sterile gloves. And then more storage specific for this booth. So that means you're going to have your wipes, your iodine, your dental bibs, and then your non-sterile gauze. So I'm gonna be stored in the table. Keep everything isolated.
I want to see you go through the door.
That's how you do it, for the most part. Then there's gonna be this. What we're talking about here was the state laws requiring us to have a second sink here for the tattoo artists. That's being worked on. That's gonna be turned into a hands washing station. Back here, this would be kind of what we would call the employee area, sort of. We keep a fridge back here, microwave, Keurig, apparently Hydrum parts. Yes, this is gonna be one of the areas. We have a food court in the mall, so we don't like have a section here. We go down to the food court. There's tables there, plenty of place to sit, eat, and we don't have to clean it. So that's pretty awesome. bathroom, of course. So, I mean, the typical.
I mean, do I need to do a 360 of this? I feel like you can kind of see everything.
I don't think a 360 is really that necessary.
Well,
make sure you can see the
pan and everything. So there's some storage up top.
Yeah.
Cabinet there, mop.
Yeah, and basically keeping supplies here. We've got our paper towels and whatnot, and then other supplies, paint stuff, things for maintenance around the store, that usual thing.
You might just walk in and show the other little cabinets
there. Yeah, and then this is the mop for tonight. And then, of course, this is where we keep a lot of our cleaning supplies regarding floors and other kind of deep cleaning kind of stuff, or anything that doesn't require just wiping glass.
And this is a private bathroom. Nobody uses it.
Yeah, this is not one for the customers. Actually, we don't have a bathroom for the customers or for the clients, simply because the mall doesn't want us to.
Well, that, and we're in a mall, and there's plenty of public restrooms.
Yeah. Mall doesn't want us using this back here, though. Now, employees-only signs will be... Employee-only signs... I broke one today. Huh. I put it up there. So that one's gonna actually be on these doors coming here. So the employees only sign will be right here on these doors. I'm sure, by the way, they're swinging, you can see why I broke it.
You can see the actual hole where it was at.
Yeah, and then same thing on the other room. That door right there is going to have an employees only sign, which it's around here somewhere. We have it here somewhere. That pretty much concludes the tour of our shop.
Do one more quick pan. Little slideshows for the clients to watch.
As usual, it's a work in progress. Thanks for joining us on the tour, guys. See you later.